Suicide Prevention Awareness Day 30, how to handle stress, anxiety, suicidal thoughts, domestic violence, narcissistic people. Today we're talking about just comparison, the comparison game. Comparing yourself to everybody else just drives more insecurity, it drives more anxiety, and it just makes you don't feel good about yourself because you're constantly trying to evaluate yourself with your peers. Your performance on the job, you're trying to meet expectations of your husband, your spouse, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your kids, trying to be a great mother, trying to be a great father, trying to be a great provider. And it's a constant hamster wheel that we're constantly trying to be better, do better, do better, do better, do better. And we're looking at all the exterior things to validate us and to gauge ourselves with. And when you start comparing yourself, that is the quickest way to make yourself feel not good enough. There's a war that everybody is fighting. And the battle and the war is you, your mind and you. And this battle is the person that you don't want to be and the person that you're trying to be. And the Apostle Paul says it great in the Bible. He says, I do the things that I don't want to do and I don't do the things that I should do. And it's a constant struggle to do the things that you know you need to do, but you're constantly doing the things that you don't want to do. And I'm just here to remind somebody here that you got to let yourself off the hook. Forgive yourself. Forgiveness for yourself for not being perfect all the time, for not making right choices. Forgive yourself for making those mistakes that you blew relationships, you blew opportunities, you've blown maybe years and years of your life and you feel like you wasted so much time. Forgive yourself. No sense beating yourself up constantly, keeping yourself chained down. If you don't forgive yourself, the only person that you're hurting is you, because you end up segregating yourself and holding yourself back and constantly living in fear, anxiety, stress, and not feeling good about yourself and depression. And that depression just bubbles over into suicidal thoughts, and you just feel like the best and the only way out is to not be alive anymore, because you feel like you're just one big screw up and that you can't handle any more screw ups. You're just in such a fragile state. Forgive yourself. You're human. You're not going to be perfect. You're not going to always get things right all the time, but you can at least make an effort to try to do the little things to do that you can do right, which is maybe holding down a job. Maybe it is, you know, saying I'm sorry when you hurt somebody. Maybe it is extending forgiveness for people who have hurt you and just freely forgiving them so that you don't have to carry that hurt and that bitterness and that resentment, that anger inside of you. And then maybe you can find some peace and rest with the war and the that you have on the inside in your mind and in your body, that you can finally find some rest and not be fighting with yourself. I constantly fight with myself, and I'm in the biggest battle with myself. I don't compete with anybody. The person I'm competing with is me, and the person that I hold to the highest standards is myself. I don't hold anybody else to those high standards. I've tried to do that, and it just never goes great at all, because not everybody can hold that standard that I put on them. And honestly, it's not fair for them. I can't put my expectations on somebody else for them to meet, because if they can't meet my expectations, then I'm the one who gets let down. But you know what? Maybe it was never for them to have those expectations that I want for them. And maybe I just need to allow them to live their lives the way they want to live their life. And I can't force people to do the things that I'm doing or be a certain way. I have to be able to roll with it and roll with things. And that comes with not fighting with yourself and not having such high expectations for other people. Because when you fight with yourself, you're so wound up so tight that you need to keep everything in order, because if something goes out of whack, you're out of whack because you're so wound up tight and you need to keep this control on everything. And I can't tell you so much more important is you got to relinquish of trying to have control over people, trying to have control over external things that are beyond your control. And the only thing you can control is how you feel about yourself, and not comparing yourself to your peers. Okay, there is no time frame to get married. There is no time frame to have kids. There is no specific time frame to finish college or start that career or launch that business. The time frame is your time frame. Okay, I read a great thing in the book once, is that comparison is never valid, because when you compare yourself to somebody else, it's not really a real comparison, because each and every single one of us has been brought up differently. We've come from different backgrounds, different environments. We have different families. We're different heritage. We have different education, right? So it's not a proper comparison, okay? Because you're comparing to orange to apples. If you want to compare and have a great comparison, you got to compare apples to apples, okay? But we are all different, okay? The fact that we've grown up in different environments and have different cultures, it's not a right comparison. So comparing yourself to what other people are doing and seeing where you are in your performance and if you're a great person or not is not really a valid comparison. How you know is how you feel on the inside. And how you get that is you got to let yourself off the hook and forgive yourself and stop looking for social media or for your friends or strangers to validate how great of a person you are. Like yourself first, okay? Before anybody else likes you, like yourself first, so that when everybody else's like comes, that just will be an extra like. But at least let yourself be the first person that loves and likes yourself. And maybe you can find some peace in your heart and your soul, and be able to not be fighting internally so much and in your mind, and having your mind defeat you over and over and over again. I've struggled with this every single day, fighting with myself, fighting with my performance, fighting with if I'm good enough, am I ever going to be good enough, you know, fighting with being loved, am I lovable, can I ever be loved, can I ever receive love in a very close way, or is it just easier for me to allow things to fall apart, you know, or, you know, am I loving people or having the walls up too much that I haven't allowed people to really, really love me, you know? And I struggle with all of these thoughts every single day. And I gotta be honest, some days I don't allow people to love me and I hold people at a distance because I'm so guarded. But other days I have it and I can allow people to be there close with me. And I think that's just human in nature in general. We have these ups and downs, and not every day we're gonna feel, you know, wanna be kumbaya, close, close, close. But the fact that I'm trying, the fact that I've taken steps to discover myself and to understand me better is a win. And it's a win in my book. And a lot of people don't do this. They don't dig inside of themselves to fully understand where their emotions are coming from and where it stems from, ultimately, because we carry this throughout our lives. And if you don't figure this part out, you can go into relationship, to job, to environment, and you carry the same baggage with you in every place you go. So you have to resolve this, but you got to take time to understand yourself and to resolve it. And to realize, you know, I'm not perfect and we're never going to be perfect. We're constantly evolving and we're constantly growing, but there's a process that we can rest in, knowing that we're always becoming, we're never arriving. And that should be our peace that we can allow to enter into our hearts and our souls, so that we can find rest and know that, okay, I made some screw ups, and not beat yourself up over and over again and say, you know what, I could do better next time, and I will do better next time. And I'm just going to learn the process and learn from those mistakes and use it to be a better person in the future. And that's life. That's life in general. So don't be afraid to allow yourself to have that peace and understanding in your mind and your heart, and let yourself off the hook. Okay, you're still a great person. You could still do great things. You still make a difference. You still matter, and you still have great work. People still need you alive. They need you here. They need your love. They need your gifts. They need your energy. They need your presence. So do not give up the fight. You do matter. You do make a difference. And it will get better. It cannot stay bad forever. It will get better. I love you guys. And you guys have a great day. Live free and live amazingly.